بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، أما بعد. The next chapter is in regards to the virtue of crying out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وشوقاً إليه, and also crying out of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or that love, that passion to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So بابٌ في فضل البكاء من خشية الله تعالى وشوقاً إليه. Now to cry, it's something that's very virtuous in the Islamic faith. We find in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahaba, when they would cry, it would mean something. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a hadith, is reported to have told Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, that Abu Bakr, if you can't cry out of the fear of Allah or for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then at least fake it, because even that is beloved to Allah. Meaning to even fake it that you're crying out of humility in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while making dua to Him, then this is something which is very beloved in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of my teachers used to, after crying a lot, he would take his tears and he would actually like wipe it around his face. And so we asked him about it and he said, I'm warning you, it's not sunnah, it's not mustahab, it's not something I'm recommending to you to do. But I do it because I heard a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ saying that even one tear that's shed out of the fear of Allah is enough to extinguish the whole fire of Jahannam. Hence, these tears to me are very blessed. So I want to spread the barakah around me. And so this was something that he would do out of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We would also find that in the life of the Prophet ﷺ, the Prophet ﷺ himself would cry. As here in the first hadith reported by Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he says that once the Prophet ﷺ told me, recite to me some Qur'an. And so Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he was confused. He said, Ya Rasulullah, أَقْرَأُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَيْكَ أُنزِلْ. You want me to recite the Qur'an to you? It doesn't make sense. The Qur'an's been revealed to you. You know, why do you want to hear it from me? You know the Qur'an better than anyone else. Why would you want to hear my recitation? And so the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنِّي أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَسْمَعُهُ مِنْ غَيْرِي. I love that I hear the recitation of Qur'an from someone else. And so Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said that he started to recite Surah An-Nisa until he reached a certain ayah, which reminded the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of the Day of Judgment. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, حَسْبُكَ الْآنَ. Stop your recitation of the Qur'an. And Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, فَالْتَفَتُّ إِلَيْهِ فَإِذَا عَيْنَاهُ تَذْرِفَانَ. I turned to look towards the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and when I looked at him, I found him that he was crying out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another hadith here, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu says that he heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, لا يلج النار رجل بكى من خشية الله. A person who cries out of the fear of Allah won't enter the fire of Jahannam. So this is a bashara, a glad tiding. Somebody cries out of the fear of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this person won't enter the fire of Jahannam. حَتَّى يَعُودَ اللَّبَنُ فِي الضَّرْعِ. This in the Arabic language literally means, if I had to do a word-to-word translation, until the milk goes back into the udders of the milk, of the cow. Until the milk goes back into the udders of the milk of the cow, which literally means it's impossible. Milk will never go back into the udder of a cow. Hence, the Prophet ﷺ saying, a person who cries out of the fear of Allah, it's impossible for him to enter the fire of Jahannam. وَلَا يَجْتَمِعُ غُبَارٌ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَدُخَانُ جَهَنَّمُ. The Prophet ﷺ said, it is also something which is also very virtuous in the sight of Allah, to go out in the path of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet ﷺ here said, if a person gets dust on him while he's out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's impossible that the fire of Jahannam or even the smoke of Jahannam will touch that place on his body where the dust also touched. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it's impossible for the dust that a person gets on his shoes, on his clothes, when he's out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's impossible for that dust or that place on his body to also be touched by the smoke of Jahannam. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive such people. And so this is from amongst the virtues that a person gets for sacrificing to go out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the virtue for crying out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to soften our hearts We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to include us amongst those that cry out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, to guide us, to keep us and our families away from all harm. Subhanallah bihamdi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
Yeah.